1,000 injuries of Fortunato, I had borne as best as I could. But when he ventured upon insult, I vowed revenge. You who so well know the nature of my soul will not suppose, however, that I gave utterance to a threat. At length, I would be avenged. This was a point definitively settled, but the very definitiveness with which it was resolved precluded the idea of risk. I must not only punish, but punish with impunity. A wrong is unredressed when retribution overtakes its redresser. It is equally unredressed when the avenger fails to make himself felt as such to him who has done the wrong. It must be understood that neither by word nor deed had I given Fortunato cause to doubt my goodwill. I continued, as was my wont, to smile in his face, and he did not perceive that my smile now was at the thought of his immolation.
He had a weak point, this Fortunato, although in other regards he was a man to be respected and even feared. He prided himself upon his connoisseurship in wines. Few Italians have the true virtuoso spirit. For the most part, their enthusiasm is adopted to suit the time and opportunity, to practice imposture upon the British and Austrian millionaires. In paintings and gemmery, Fortunato, like his countrymen, was a quack, but in the matter of old wines, he was sincere. In this respect, I did not differ from him materially. I was skillful in Italian vintages myself, and bought largely whenever I could. It was about dusk, one evening during the supreme madness of the carnival season, that I encountered my friend. He accosted me with excessive warmth, for he had been drinking much. The man wore motley. He had on a tight-fitting party-striped dress, and his head was surmounted by the carnival cap and bells. I was so pleased to see him that I thought I should never have done wringing his hand. "My dear Fortunato, you are luckily met. How remarkably well you are looking today. But I have received a pipe of what passes for Amontillado, and I have my doubts."
"How? Amontillado? A pipe? Impossible. And in the middle of a carnival?"
"I have my doubts, and I was silly enough to pay the full Amontillado price without consulting you in the matter. You were not to be found, and I was fearful of losing a bargain."
"Amontillado?"
"I have my doubts."
"Amontillado?"
"And I must satisfy them. As you are engaged, I am on my way to Lucchesi. If anyone knows a critical turn, it is he. He will tell me."
"Lucchesi cannot tell Amontillado from Sherry. I have no engagement. Come."
"Whither?"
"To your vaults,